Alrighty, welcome guys to the very first single player episode of my Farming Simulator 2017 FDR Logging series. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to just kind of go through and start logging some blocks and playing around and kind of talking about stuff as I go. There's no real plan to this other than I'm just logging, and some people wanted to hear some commentary, maybe my thoughts on a few things if they happen to come up. So, yeah. Well, we're going to start off. This is a map. Depending on when I release this series, this might be new. This might be old by then. We'll see how things go. This map is called the Emerald Valley Logging Map. It's probably one of the most heavily treed maps I think I've ever done. Looks really pretty, really nice. Logging on it is fantastic. I've done lots of beta tests screwing around with it, and it's just gorgeous, very thick forests and fantastic times, which you guys will all get a chance to play if you're not already playing it by the time I put this video out. So we're gonna do starters here. We're gonna pick a block and decide where we want to log. So let's see here. So what I kind of went ahead and cheated a little bit on the money side because I didn't really want to work through the whole process. If you want, you can start at the bottom and cut every tree down and work your way to the top, starting with just a chainsaw, but I'm kind of past that phase now. So I'm going to go pick up some vehicles. Let's see here. We're going to need a truck, which just about landed on my head. And then we're going to need our trailer. We're going to need the other trailer. Let's get that all hooked up first, shall we? Oh! See, my trailer has landed on that other piece there. It's probably because I was standing in a weird spot, but we should be able to still hook up here, I think. There we go. The joys of physics, hey? Alright, let's see here. Well, I guess we don't wanna hook up yet. This is my first time actually playing the game in so long because I've been modding consistently so much that I don't actually ever play the game for fun anymore. So this is kind of nice. Doing this series kind of gives me the ability to have some fun with it. I'm going to grab the feller buncher and a blade. I should make sure my joy to key is on. Yes, it is. Good. Alright. I love this little buncher. Just a hoot and a holler, this thing. Dun, dun, dun. Hook onto here. So I can do my best to keep these videos not too long. I'm recording in some pretty ridiculously high quality now, so well, it's ridiculously high for my internet standards anyway, so hopefully I can keep these to about maybe 20 to 30 minutes long. Although I'm not keeping count right now, so anything could happen. I'll probably just stop it after I bring all my machines to the bush and get it all set up. There we go. And you always want to make sure you shut these machines off, otherwise the tracks like to run rampant while you're driving around. Well, first we should actually decide where we want to go. So this is the Emerald Valley Logging Map. I'm still trying to get the PDA right, because for some reason when you're in block 4, you're actually like in the water. I don't know, I'm trying to figure out what the hell is causing that. But so what do we got here? There's a lot of blocks in this one, so I'm thinking I'll take something not too far away. Maybe we'll take number 5. So when we come off the main road, we go right and just keep going right to the end. Seems pretty straightforward. We'll take block 5 today. Then we'll get a nice view of the water and the mountains and all that pretty stuff. So let's see what happens. I'm still working on a way to make these low beds carry these machines a little better. The only advice I can tell you now is don't drive like a maniac. They still tend to slide around because they are very heavy machines, but I don't know. Take it easy. Alright, so, what'd we say? Go to the right. and then just keep going straight. I'm actually pretty excited about this little map. I'm excited just to log it because it's so dense and full of goodness. Whoops. Oh, see? Look what happened right off the bat. I gotta fix that. That drives me nuts. It is such a pain in the butt trying to keep these machines on these trailers. Doesn't matter what I do. It's something to do with the weight. I've increased the weight of the machines to keep them from being so bouncy. And in... see, they still bounce even with the weight. And in turn, it's added a whole new ball of annoyance by making them slide on the trailers. But you literally have to make those machines weigh like one, I guess you'd call them tons, in order to actually make them work. And that drives me nuts as well, because you can't have heavy trees in that case. So for the meantime, like everybody else who's playing the game, you gotta just kinda pick them up if they fall off the trailer. Oh my god. This is the best start to a video series I've ever had. I'm wondering what changed on this thing. I wonder if it's because the head's touching the back? I don't know. Once it gets operating in the bush, it's fantastic. Getting it to the bush? That's a whole nother problem. So let's see here. Okay, I'm not going to put the head down. I'm just going to leave the head in the air. Maybe for some reason it's lifting it off the trailer or something. I don't know. But clearly I can tell I got some more modding playing around to do after this. Let's watch it as we go here. It's when it bounces, I'm pretty sure that's what causes it. I'm thinking it was the head, actually, that was sitting on the back of the trailer. Because it seems to be sitting alright now. Well, better now. Alright, let's whip up this hill. Hopefully it won't fall off again. Whoa, whoa, just gotta learn how to drive. There we go. Alright, let's park our buncher. What else do we need? We need a processor. And then we'll worry about the logging truck and all that goodies. Processor, skidder for sure. And we'll just park this big mammoth right over here. Put our head down on the ground, be all professional here. And a lot of people have been asking about this truck as well. This truck is really heavy. That's why it takes a little bit to get going, but it adds a little bit more realism to gear shifting and kind of makes it a little more realistic, because in real life, these things don't exactly fire off and go right off the bat neither, so. Bumpy little windy-ass road here. But once you get her up to full speed, she goes pretty good. I'm also driving with my keyboard, which is very naughty. I highly recommend using either an analog controller, like thumbsticks, what are those called? Steering wheels. That's the one I'm looking for. Because the steering wheels will give you a much smoother thingy-doo. Okay, so this is another thing. This is the new fixed processor, based off a Caterpillar 325D, another beautiful little machine. I just recently had Polygonish build this for me. See, they got it available on their site now with a bucket, so that's pretty cool too. But yeah, this guy will be out, like I said, depends on when I release this video, it might already be out. If not, it probably won't be too far after. But yeah, the inside looks a little bit better. It's pretty tight for visibility. I think it's a little bit harder to see in this guy, but it's, I don't know. I don't know what it is about it. I just enjoy driving it a lot more than the JD one. But that's a good processor too. I mean, they're both pretty wicked. So let's not put the head down this time and see what happens. I'm thinking that was what was causing it to bounce. Probably every time it shifted, it would catch the head on the back, and then it, beautiful physics engine probably made it slide. Oof, that's a heavy freaking machine, man. Alright, here we go. There we go. Yeah, she seems to be sitting a lot better. So don't put the head down, apparently. I didn't even know that. I've been modding this game for, what, almost 2 years? The things you learn. I guess I should actually play the game once in a while. Maybe that would help my odds in modding. In the words of my one of my favorite photographers, sometimes you've got to just pet the whale. Oh, she looks like she's sliding off there pretty good now. There you go. We're so close, too. This will be the boringest video of my video series. Watching me reload trailers consistently over the day. Oh. There we go. Let's try this again. I'm gonna switch to my wacky view. There we go. Stay, processor, stay. Good processor, sit. We're a very yellow team of equipment here today. Yeah, there might be... I don't know what I can do to make that better. I wonder if I widen the tires on the trailer, maybe? I don't know. I always try to think of ideas to make the trailer. I really missed the locking script. That used to be pretty wicked. Because in 2015 there was that wicked locking script, and that would ensure the vehicles basically had no weight and turned them off as an object while you were carrying it, which was really nice. And in this game there was supposed to be some sort of a dynamic locking script, but it doesn't seem to work on machines over a certain weight. So, me of course having some of the most ridiculously heavier machines to support the silly ass log physics in this game, I have to make them a bit heavier. But whatever. You know what? We do what we can, right? We do what we can. Whoa. I'm going to apologize in advance when I'm running these machines. I don't know how my mic's going to do here, but I have a funny feeling it's going to pick up all my clickety-clickety-clicks of my joysticks while I'm working, so if you hear consistent clicking and slapping around and stuff, that's it's the sound of all the joysticks clicking and clacking. Alright, what else do we need out there? We need a skidder, which I should probably... I'm just going to drive the skidder out there, I think. I'm not going to try to load that. We'll need a loader. Let's get a grapple loader out there, too. I think this is the last thing I need to bring out here. Thank God, because I didn't really want to bring any more out there. My low bed's a little floating in the air there. I probably could have dropped that in a better spot. But you know what? That's where it is, so... Hi-ho, that's what we get. Let's try to center it a bit here. Yeah, like, I've even gone as far as to try to put edges on this trailer. Actually, I don't know if there's edges. There is edges on it, see? I have edges on the trailer. And still, it still slips off. Drives me bonkers. Hook up and roll. Just dragging the metal now. Well, at least you know the truck's tough. The other thing I was thinking about doing was maybe raising my, making the tires bigger on the back of that low bed. I don't know if that would help or not, but maybe to help balance it a bit so it doesn't quite bounce around as much. Keeps it from sliding. Oh man, she's gonna fall off already. Case. Man, oh man. You know what? It would almost be quicker sometimes to just drive these things into the bush. Well, Who loves this physics engine? I know I don't. Oh, good lord. Come on, son. Come on, son. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna try something weird. I'm gonna try parking it up on an angle like that. Oh, no. I don't think that'll work. What if I lock it right in there? Doesn't look very realistic because it's clipping through the sides, but hey, man, if it'll help chance a better load out there, we'll try it. Oh, that doesn't look like it's helping our odds at all. Well, maybe. I don't know. Let's just see how fast we can get it out there so it doesn't fall off. I know the more bumps and turns you make, the higher chance it's going to fall off. I want to say it's doing well back there. Oh, here's a bump. Oh, ooh, oh. Oh, no, she's slipping off that side. Don't do it. Don't do it. Come on, we're so close. Ah, you bugger. Out of respect for the children, I'm going to try my best not to swear on this series, but it's still probably going to be rated 18+, so I'm going to say a lot of gosh darn it, that's for sure. Alright, here we go. Thread the needle. Remember when I first started YouTubing stuff, and I thought to myself, how the hell do people talk to themselves for so long while they're recording videos? It must be a level of insanity. And then I started doing YouTubing, and now I think I'm just as insane as the rest of them, so. Go be a modder for a year. That'll really sort out your sanity problems. Oh, look at that cool little gully through there. See, like, I don't even plan this stuff when I'm building the maps. It's just random tree dropping, but I think it'd be these little gullies and stuff everywhere. This is going to be fun to log this. It's going to be good times. At least we better park this thing. Look, it's Team Yellow. And then we're going to throw a green skidder in there to really screw up the whole works. This crying shame of a thing. That's it. I'm gonna drive the skidder out here. I'm not going through this again. That's kind of why I'm tending to make smaller maps too right now. Like, this isn't a very, well, I wouldn't say it's small. It's actually retardedly big, but it's not like long distances between each blocks or anything. The block distances are pretty close, so you can literally walk a machine to another block if you need to. And until I get something working for the trailers, yeah, I'll just have to kind of stick with that plan. But so far, so good. Yeah, but I was excited to kind of make a single-player channel. I'm still trying to get multiplayer working, but I haven't had any luck. I've been testing it with a couple buddies in the dedicated, and we just can't get the machines working with the, what I assume is a dumbed-down level of physics that they have on those servers. We were thinking about maybe trying to host our own little, like private servers or whatever the heck, where you host it from home, as opposed to using a dedicated, because those seem to work really well, but, yeah, not for the rest of it. Alright, let's lock this guy up. We don't really need to bring this out right away, though. This trailer can sit here for a while. I'll just shut this guy down. And now, get ourselves a skidar. A bunch of guys were pissed off that I made this green. Everybody, because it's technically a cat body, but I made it green. I just had too many yellow vehicles. I don't know. I was just getting tired of having yellow. I was like, well, why don't we just have something that's not yellow? Some kind of John Deere colors. Change it up a bit. I like how this road is like all white. I don't know why it's white. Must be the texture terrain or something. But hey, at least we know exactly where we've been anyway. It's like our tires are all dropping calcium or something. It's like that and over here too. Oh no, see, it's brown there. Must be just the gravel texture leaves behind this color. But hey, if you're playing multiplayer with your buddies, at least you'll know pretty much what road they're on. Alrighty. Bring this guy into the block. And then what we're going to do is we're going to run around for a minute and plan out our attack on this block. I hate that you can't... Oh, I know why. I always forget to change the stop and go braking. Change that. There you go. That allows you to back up without having the machine totally stopped, which is convenient as beans. There we go, nice little lineup. So, we're going to plan out how we're going to attack this block here. Now our PDA is going to be all out to lunch. Oh, it's actually not too far off, even though we're standing kind of over here. Whatever, doesn't matter. So, we have a whole crap load of trees going right to the water. We could go up this hill and connect to this hill. Or we could go up towards block 3. Decisions, decisions. We're probably going to cut this section out right here and this section and just clean up this whole island. It's going to be a lot of wood, but we could probably do it. So this is the island right over here. Let's just take a little wander through the bushes. You know what I wish you could have spray paint cans. I've been looking into trying to figure out something that'll do that. I mean, I know in future or past versions we've just placed objects to, actually, I wonder what kind of placeable objects they got. Buildings. Placeables. Towers. We don't need a whole tower. That'd be ridiculous. Like a red sign or something. That'd be stellar. Why can't we put stop signs down? I'm sure I could mod something in like that. But make a placeable, then you could like outline a block where you want to cut. But I guess we'll just eyeball this one. So I'd say that big ass mountain, beautiful. Excellent. When you guys do get to this map, you'll notice you can't really see distant trees. Like there's trees all over there. But I had to make a bit of a sacrifice and cut it back in the editor because this is one of the most graphic intensive maps you guys will ever play. Well, I mean, technically you can go to your graphics and lower them as much as you want, but I have pretty much everything on full and I'm running a Titan XP now, and if I crank everything to the absolute max, I still can slow that bugger down. But yeah, there's a lot of trees, so do be weary of the trees. Yeah, this will be in here, might be a little tricky, but we might have to cut them and bring them up the hill and drop them in here somewhere. I just want to see kind of where this goes. A little bit of a hill back here. That's what skitters are for. And now I'm lost in the woods again. See, this is cool. This is what I like. I like when it's so busy looking in the bush that I don't know where the hell I am. I mean, technically you have a map, but, you know, when you're cutting, it's so fun because you make these little roads into the bush and it's just absolutely stunning. So this must be the end of that edge. Let's just go right over here. Yeah, this is the end of the island over here. So we'll cut right up into here. And even back further. Cool. Alright. Let's take a look here. Wow, there's a lot of trees in here. You know when you're map editing, you're like, man, I put a lot of trees in there. But then you actually get in the game and you're like, holy crap, I did put a lot of trees in there. My last map, I think, had 27,000 or some ridiculous thing. But I finally built a macro when I'm map editing to place these trees really quickly and really painlessly now. So, I mean, it still takes a lot of time, like a few hours to place them, but it's a lot better than the 5 or 6 hours it used to take. All right, well, I think I'm going to stop this video here for the beginning, now that we got all our equipment out here. In the next video, we're going to start off with the little buncher, and we're going to start cleaning all the way to the end of this island, I think. But like I said, I want to kind of keep these videos kind of short and sweet so that everything uploads properly, and we don't have 40-minute-long videos. And if people find these interesting and like them, then yeah, I'll continue to make them longer or change things about them, but I'll leave that to your guys' feedback when we get there. All right, one sec here. I guess we better save. Sure, we're all caught up. All right, we're good to go. We'll see you guys on the next episode.